Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Today I'm going to show you a revolutionary two-bit quantization for large language models and how a quantized mixture 8x7B model can run with high generation quality on three-tier collab. If you look at the open source language models community, you will find that there has been an increasing demand to make open source language models more accessible to end users for local inference and fine-tuning. However, this requires the models to significantly reduce their computational resource demands, allow their usage on more affordable hardware. A particularly effective method is called quantization. Practically, quantization is a technique that lowers the bit width used for presenting the weights of a model, which effectively decreases its overall size and eases memory transfer. If you're interested in the basic concept of quantization and its usage in large language models, I recommend you to read this article from Ivan Resnikov that introduces the technique clearly from basic knowledge of computer number type and precision to several common ways of weight conversion and the recovery process between 16-bit float to 8-bit integer. Among this approach, the concepts are very similar, and the biggest difference is the complexity of their algorithms and weight conversion. However, this creates a trade-off between size and accuracy, especially for heavy compression of models, which can be easily reflected through perplexity, a metric indicating the predictive capability of the model. To handle this situation, a team from Australia recently released a new state-of-the-art method for 2-to-3-bit with LLM quantization, AQLM, additive quantization of language model. In a paper that differs fundamentally from some previous method which normally required complicated formats to manage quantitative outliers. Before we dive deeper to the algorithm of AQLM, let's quickly see the performance of it. As we all know, to evaluate a quantization method, two factors are normally concerned: perplexity and speed. From the comparison results of QIP, AQLM, and the baseline of 0.16, for the three scale of Llama 2 models, it's surprised to see the AQLM 2-bit is always performed better than QUIP 2-bit 70B model, and the AQLM 2-bit scores 4 in perplexity on Wikitext 2 benchmark, which is much better than the original 13B model with 16-bit. For me, when the perplexity score is under 4, the model inference is qualified for use in practical application. And the speed performance running on NVIDIA RTX 3019 GPU is also in the range of acceptance compared to the original one. Here is a simple explanation of the AQLM process. AQLM is a lookup table-based algorithm designed to compress the weights of the training model while preserving the performance as much as possible. It does this by representing the weights using a summation of vectors from multiple codebooks. The weights are split into groups, and each group is quantized separately. Each group of weights, which contain several elements, is replaced with a sum of several vectors choosing from these codebooks. Each codebook holds a set of vectors, also called code, and each vector is encoded using several bits, let's say 16 bits or 8 bits. When reconstructing the weights, you pick up one vector from
the each of the code blocks.
Now let's move on to add them together.
In this demo, we will use the original AQLM transformers
to run inference on a compressed version of the Mixtral 8x7B model in 2-bit on the free tier of Google Colab with only 13 gigabytes T4 GPU. Mixtral 8x7B is a sparse mixture of experts model provided by Mixtral AI and proved its performance by outperforming Llama 270B on generation quality entirely with 6x faster speed, and particularly match or outperforms GPT 3.5 on most benchmarks. With 32K tokens context, this open source model is pretty much usable for practical generative applications. Mixtral has 76.7B total parameters, but only used 12.9B parameters per token, which supports much of its inference speed. However, even a Mixtral 7B needs a GPU with 24 gigabytes VRAM for inference, so it will require almost 64 gigabytes for a well-facilitated Mixtral 8x7B model, and that costs as much as around $4.5 per hour. Now, by using the 2-bit AQLM version, we can run this model for totally free on the Colab notebook. First, you should install the AQLM library with GPU specification to involve CUDA-related packages. Also, you'd have to install the Accelerate library and an AQLM branch of the Transformers library directly from GitHub repository for latest AQLM update. Then we should load the model, but there's no much difference in using Hugging Face's Transformers method to load a model to local memory. To find AQLM compressed models, please visit Black Samurai's page on Hugging Face. Successfully loading the model, we can do a quick testing for a text completion task. We will use the generate method that input a start text like the relationship between human and AI, and then print the decoded output. From the output, you can see the relationship between human and AI is a complex one. On the one hand, AI has the potential to improve our lives in many ways. It can help us to make better decisions, to solve problems, blah, blah, blah. And the time it used for generation is about 32.1 seconds. That is quite good. Then we can do an instruction-based prompt to do an advanced test. And please be note that the Mixtral 8x7B V0.1 is the base model that has not been fine-tuned for instruction or chat. But it is still possible to refine the prompt to ask the model to respond with a decent answer. First, we struct the prompt with system, user and assistant structure, and then we define a parse text method to only print the assistant response by filter the output. Moving forward, we are going to build the pipeline for text generation, and then we call the pipe method to ask the model to generate a blog post of traveling in Bohe Island. Let's see the output. Hello, I'm a travel blog writing about Bohe Island. I'm going to share my experience in Bohe Island and the island in Philippines. Bohe Island is a beautiful island located in Philippines. It's known for its stunning beaches. That is good. And it cost me 3 minutes, 9 seconds to generate this blog post, which is a little longer than I expect, but the content is fairly accepted, considering this is not a fine-tuned version of an instruction model. A more instruction-capable model with AQM 2-bit was released recently. Here, you can try it by yourself. And let's see the overall consuming of GPU after the test. The GPU usage is still under 14 gigabytes so far. Next, I try a simple code instruction that asks the model to write a short Python code to calculate factorial. And the model generates an explanation with a code snippet that can be executed correctly. Here, very simple code. In conclusion, it is always worth observing advancements in quantization, as cost reductions in open source models play a pivotal role in fostering sustainable AI business development. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.